In this video, you'll learn how to configure conversions in GA4, Google Analytics 4. Conversions are used to report on the most important actions taking place on your website. For example, you might want to report on the number of people completing a form on your website, making a purchase, or another important action. Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. Today we're going to look at configuring a classic goal based on people viewing a thank you page after completing a form. Once you've configured conversions in GA4, you'll be able to understand the performance of your marketing channels, make use of the attribution reports, and more. Okay, let's get started. I'm in my GA4 demo property, so let's select Reports. Then engagement, and then events. We're now looking at all of the events that have been collected for the current date range, and we can see a number of different events. These include page view, purchase, scroll, video events, and more. Most of these, like page views and scrolls, are automatically tracked by Google Analytics using the GA4 enhanced measurement feature. And since I have edit level permission for the property, as I hover over each row, there are three vertical dots on the right. Selecting the vertical dots lets me mark an event as a conversion. Or if an event is already being used to report conversions, I can unmark the event as a conversion. If you don't have the option to mark or unmark events as a conversion, then you'll need to have your permission increased, or get someone who does have edit level permission to configure conversions for you. And if you're sending purchase events to GA4, these are automatically marked as conversions. So we can use the default events report to enable events as conversions in Google Analytics. But since we can't see which events are already configured as conversions, I prefer to do this another way. Let's take a look. Let's navigate to Admin. And then select Events in the Property column. Again, we can see all of the events that have been collected, but this time it's easy to tell if an event has been marked as a conversion or not by looking at the column on the right. Okay, so if you see the event you would like to report as a conversion and you have edit level permission, you can simply click the button to enable the event as a conversion. Once enabled, every time the event is collected into GA4, a conversion will also be counted in your reports. This is perfect if you wanted to track people watching videos or scrolling, but if we were to enable the page view event as a conversion, then every time someone views a page on our website, a conversion would be counted. However, this doesn't work if you only want to track a thank you page or confirmation page as a conversion in Google Analytics. If you want to track a specific page as a conversion, like a thank you page, then you'll need to track that individual page as a unique event first. There are two ways to do this. The first option is to create a new event inside Google Analytics based on an existing event. For example, we can trigger a new event when a page view is reported for our thank you page. This is the easiest option since everything can be set up inside Google Analytics. The second option is to configure a new tag in Google Tag Manager that will send an event every time someone views the thank you page. For example, we could send an event called Generate Lead when someone completes the form on our website. We're going to start by looking at the first option where we trigger a new event inside Google Analytics. Let's head back to Google Analytics. Let's select Create Event. And now let's click Create. I want to track people viewing my thank you page as a separate event, so I'm going to name my event Generate_Lead. And now we need to configure the conditions for when we want this event to be triggered. Let's enter Event_Name, then equals, and let's enter Page_View. This ensures that we're only matching page view events. Now let's click Add Condition. and we're going to enter page underscore location, then contains, and let's enter thank-u. This will mean that our new event will trigger every time someone views a page on our website that has a URL containing thank you. Let's leave copy parameters from the source event selected. This will mean all of the parameters from the original page view event are also available in the new event when it's triggered. And here's an optional step. Let's click Add Modification. And let's enter value as the parameter name, and 50 as the value. Now let's click Add Modification again, and let's name the parameter currency, and enter USD as the value. Adding these two parameters to our new event means we're assigning a value of $50 every time someone converts. You can adjust this to the value of your particular conversion and your preferred currency. Now let's click Create. We've now created a new event that will be triggered when someone views a page with a URL containing thank you on our website. Once someone views a page that matches our condition, you'll then be able to see the event in the real-time report straight away. However, it typically takes 12 to 24 hours for conversions to appear in the standard reports. So if someone visits the thank you page now, I recommend checking back tomorrow to see it in your reports. Okay, let's close this. Since you won't see your new event straight away, you can wait until it shows up to enable it as a conversion. Or you can pre-configure your event as a conversion in advance. This means that once the event is triggered, it will also be marked as a conversion. To do this, let's select Conversions in the Property column. And let's click New Conversion Event. Now we need to enter the name of our conversion event exactly as we named it when it was created. Continuing our example, this would be generate underscore lead, all in lowercase. Now we can click Save. Once our event is triggered, it'll also be counted as a conversion. And if you're wondering, you can enable up to 30 unique events as conversions in GA4. So you should have plenty of scope to track all of those important actions as conversions. And if you start getting close to this limit, then you can consider reducing the number of uniquely named events you're using and make use of a custom parameter to view more granular details. Now let's take a look at where you can see conversions reported in Google Analytics. Let's select Reports. Then engagement, and then conversions. I previously configured the conversion we've been looking at today, so this means I already have data in my demo property. If you've only just configured your conversion, then you will need to wait until it's been triggered before you begin to see conversions in this report. We can see all of our conversion events, and we can select an individual event to see more details. We can now see the default channel group, or how people are finding our website before they convert. And we can see the total number of conversions and any conversion value we've defined for the action. You can change the dimension used for the report, so you might want to change this to source, medium, or campaign. And you can also find your conversions in the other reports. For example, let's select Acquisition, and then User Acquisition. If we scroll to the right, we can also see conversions in this report. And selecting the drop-down lets you choose an individual conversion event. Okay, but what if you want to trigger an event based on a custom action and use that as a conversion in Google Analytics? Well, in that case, you're probably going to want to use Google Tag Manager. Let's head to Google Tag Manager to take a look. We can see we have an existing GA4 configuration tag. This tag will automatically send events, including page views, to Google Analytics. We're going to create a new tag for our conversion. So let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Conversion. Now let's select Tag Configuration. And let's choose GA4 Event as the tag type. We need to select our existing GA4 configuration tag. And let's name the event generate_lead. Now let's select event parameters. And let's click add row. We're going to assign a value for each conversion, so let's enter value as the parameter name. And let's enter 10 as the value. This means we'll be reporting $10 as the average conversion value. This is optional. Now let's add another row and enter currency as the parameter name and USD as the value. And let's add one more row. Let's enter page_location as the parameter name. And let's click the variable icon and choose page URL. Now let's select advanced settings and under tag firing options, let's select once per page, so that our GA4 event tag only fires once per page. Now let's select triggering. And we need to create a new trigger that will only fire our GA4 event tag when someone views a thank you page on our website. Let's click the blue plus sign. Let's name our trigger any thank you page. And let's select trigger configuration. You can create triggers for any action you'd like, but we're going to create a trigger that fires the tag based on the URL of the page someone is viewing on our website. So let's select page view, and then some page views. Now I'm going to select page URL, contains, and I'm going to enter thank-you. This will mean that our tag is triggered whenever someone views a page that contains thank you in the URL. Now let's click save. And let's save the tag. You can now preview the changes to test them on your website, but I'm happy with the new tag, so I'm going to publish the changes to my website. You can apply the same technique to any other actions you want to track as conversions into Google Analytics. The main thing is that you'll need to create a trigger that will fire the GA4 event tag once someone has completed your desired action. So this could be submitting a form, it could be clicking a button, viewing a page, or any other action you choose. And just to highlight, we've covered two options you can use to create events in Google Analytics. We've walked through the steps to create a new event based on an existing event in GA4, and how to send a custom event to GA4 using Google Tag Manager. For each conversion you want to track, you only need to use one of these options. You don't need to do both. Once you've enabled an event as a conversion, you'll begin to see it reported as a conversion in Google Analytics. What events are you going to track as conversions? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel for all of my latest tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.